At the National Center for Advancing Translational Sciences, or NCATS, we have a number of programs that are focused on making a difference for rare diseases. There are about 7,000 rare diseases. We have a treatment for less than 5%. Most of them affect children. The investment that has been made into rare diseases research is not really sufficient to bring more treatments to more patients. The Genetic and Rare Diseases Information Center, or GARD, is an online platform that provides one-stop, high-quality information to the public, to patients, to researchers. It has in-depth information, but also links to other organizations and further resources. The toolkit for patient-focused therapy development was born out of many interactions with patient groups who wanted to exchange knowledge, exchange best practices, share know-how, so it would be easier for patient groups at different stages in the process to engage with the therapy development process. We divided the process up into four phases. One is discovery research, one getting ready for clinical trials, implementing clinical trials, and then what happens once the trial's done and people have told us that they found it very useful in their quest to figure out how to best advance rare diseases research in their disease. We have a program that is called the Rare Diseases Clinical Research Network, or RDCRN. This is a group of consortia. Each of them works on at least two or three rare diseases, and they follow the same protocols, the same methodology, the same data management framework by all collaborating with one data management center that we fund. We have, in fact, at least one patient group be part of each of our networks. And all the patient groups together, in turn, form a coalition of patient groups and exchange know-how, exchange best practices. The RDCRN has studied about 200 rare diseases, trained over 200 rare diseases researchers, and has enrolled over 40,000 patients. The Therapeutics for Rare and Neglected Diseases program at NCATS has worked with many patient groups, with many industry partners, with many academic researchers, and really advanced programs. It helps them with methods, infrastructure, resources that can bridge a gap that has occurred, that can get them across a bottleneck in their preclinical development, so that in partnership they can move this therapy development initiative forward and they can get it into the clinical phase and de-risk it sufficiently so that it can be taken up by others. NCATS brings the infrastructure, the research resources, the methods, the know-how across the board for any indication, and the partners bring the knowledge of the particular disease, bring the question, bring the unmet need to the program. The Rare Diseases Registry Program, or RADAR, is meant to help rare diseases communities with establishing registries. Registries are very important. They help us understand where patients are, how many patients there are to some degree, and then also what symptoms they have and how their disease progresses. There's great opportunity right now to make a difference for rare diseases. We understand in many cases what causes them, and we know enough about the biology to make a difference.